Let's take a look at the SAS 9.4 Base Programming Performance-Based Exam. I'll show you what the first few minutes of the exam looks like and how you get your lab set up. Right now, the lab is finishing up its configuration, and you note that we've got this little screen for you to look at while that's occurring, a little preview of what the lab is going to look like. What we're doing is we are waiting for the next button to appear here in the bottom. And there it is. A quick survey about your programming experience. And one final hold screen. The exam is making sure that the lab is up and running and is available. And once it is, you get this message and the next button appears. We do that to make sure that when the clock starts ticking, everything is ready to go. So everything loads up automatically at the beginning. Note that we are inside of a 5-minute preparation period. We can see that we're pointing out the true exam clock has not started. We use this time to get the lab configured, and we're going to complete some introduction tasks. This is the same format that you'll see during the exam portion, where you'll have some instructions in the top, followed by some questions that you'll answer in the bottom. So we start talking about the environment, how you can slide things around. It doesn't happen here, but sometimes you may get a message about an incompatible browser or a warning about cookies. Those messages can be dismissed. Buttons up here allow you to adjust the windows. I'll get into that in just a moment. First, I'm going to pop on to the next section, and I'm going to go ahead and start one of the SAS user interfaces. In this case, I'm going to demonstrate SAS Studio, but we also have Enterprise Guide and the traditional Display Manager. So it starts to open the window. This menu can be minimized to show more of the screen, and just start sliding things around to get a comfortable space, right? What we want to do is we want to minimize the need to scroll, right? If I make the windows too large, say I went to the maximum size here, and then maximized my user interface, a lot of scrolling required, and that's not going to be a fun exam experience. So what we want to do is we want to try to find an environment that is more conducive to the space that we have available. I'm working on a fairly small monitor with only 768 vertical pixels. So that's not uncommon maybe for some Pearson test centers that may be a little small. Hopefully you'll get something that has at least 1,000 vertical pixels. It's also an advantage of online proctoring because you have control of your monitor size. So once we get things kind of situated in a comfortable space with some slack around the outside, we can go on to the next task, and we're going to look at how the keyboard is configured. So the lab is initially configured as a US English keyboard, but keyboards are different in different parts of the world, and you're going to have a tough time finding a semicolon if you're using a German keyboard. That would be difficult in a programming environment. So you can adjust. Here's the different keyboards that we have available that can be configured. And once your user interface is clicked, so that's key, make sure that that is clicked. And once it's clicked, you can then change to whichever keyboard is appropriate for your site. Since I'm using US English, I will go back to that, right? You hit a few critical keys for your programming to verify that they work. And with that complete, we can go on to the next task. And that's going to talk about documentation, right? So we do give you access to SAS documentation during your exam. We've got some bookmarks across the top for the root level base programming guide, as well as quick shortcuts to procedures, functions, and formats. Now, you don't have access to Google. You don't have access to SAS communities, but you do have access to documentation. And we point out with some notes over here, right, the documentation access in this environment is not the fastest, and it can impede the performance of SAS a little bit while you're trying to run your programs. So we would recommend that you keep the windows closed when you're not using them, and don't Don't expect to depend too much on documentation during your exam, but it's there if you need it. Just a couple last little pointers. Tell you how many programming projects to expect and what the weight of those questions are, followed by a number of regular exam questions and what the weight of them are. And then finally, a last minute, when you click next, everything's going to start. Pointing out the lab is going to disappear briefly when transitioning from one project to the next. That's normal. Everything comes back just like it was. So we get the warning, the message about going on to the next lab to proceed. The next time we hit the next button, we will go into the exam environment. The actual exam clock will start and you'll see your first lab activities. Thanks for watching and good luck with your exam attempt.